Hi guys, welcome back to A Homemade Chef. My name is Veena Azmanov. You may also know me for my other channel, Veena's Out of Cakes. This is clover leaf bread. It's a very popular recipe on my blog. Some of you have already tried it and requested for the video. So here it is. The ingredients I have right now are 1.5 cup of warm milk. I have, see me sticking my finger in, that's to show it's warm. It should be about 100-110 degrees Fahrenheit, no more, no less, okay? And that basically just means that it's warm. So I have sugar, yeast, salt, milk, but melted butter, egg, flour. Okay, now first thing I'm going to do is add 2.5 teaspoons of yeast. I'm using instant dry yeast, this is the brand I like, but any brand will do as long as it's instant dry yeast. And it actually can be put directly into the flour. I just prefer to do it like this because I'm used to it. So in goes the yeast, in goes the sugar. This is 2 tablespoons of sugar. Now all the ingredients are in the beginning of this recipe video, bottom of this video, as well as on my blog. So on my blog you have a picture tutorial. So it's the same recipe, just that I did it before on my blog. So in went the melted butter and the egg, okay? All in all, now I've got salt left to put in the flour. The recipe says 500 to 600 grams of flour, and I have put 500 grams of flour here and 1 tablespoon of salt. Now I may or may not need the last 100 grams of flour depending on the consistency of the flour and the liquid, okay? So it's important that you keep that 100 grams of flour on the side, just so that you may or may not need it. It's the consistency of the dough that you make as you make it, okay? Now the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use my dough attachment and mix it. Now on my blog I've shown you how to do this by hand, so here I'm using a mixer just to speed things up. So okay, now you want to make sure that all the liquid ingredients are mixed well with the dry ingredients before you add any more flour, okay? Now it's very important that you do not over mix as well as under mix your bread dough. You need to make sure that the dough has gluten activated in it, so it's very, very important that you actually mix the dough really well. Kneading is a very important part of making bread, so if you don't have a mixer you have to knead it by hand, and you probably will need about 10 minutes of kneading, okay? Yes, it is a little bit of an effort to get bread dough kneaded because you do want to make the gluten activated. Now in the mixer I'm going to put the timer on for about 5 minutes, you will see, and then leave the timer on just for, with the mixer running for one on the low speed, about 1. You do not want to use your bread dough on a very high speed in the mixer because you just want to kind of knead it nice and slow. Okay, you see that all is mixed. Now you can see it's a very sticky dough, and you know, doesn't have any smoothness at all. The gluten is not at all activated. Now I'm going to put the mixer on for timer on 5 minutes and I'll show you what I do. So after 5 minutes, here we go. I want to show you what, see how smooth that is? Now all the gluten is activated. It's still sticky, so I'm still going to need a little bit of flour, but you see I haven't just made haste in putting the flour in the beginning. I want to make sure that all the liquid is well absorbed into the flour before I add any flour. Okay, now all I need is a little flour to get all the flour to leave the sides of the bowl. So I'm going to add about 1.5 tablespoons right now, okay, and see if I need more. You see those strands of gluten? All that is, all those thready, that's all. If you stretch the dough, you should be able to stretch it like that. That's the gluten activated, this elasticity in the dough, which is very, very important. Okay. If you're doing it by hand, you probably want to see my recipe on the blog because I show you exactly how to test the recipe if you're mixing it by hand, okay? Now, probably 1 tablespoon more just so that it'll leave the sides of the bowl. There we go. I'm just going to add some flour on my bench surface over here just so that I can get it all incorporated. I'm going to take a bowl and add some oil in the bowl. Oil the bowl nicely so I can proof the dough in the bowl. Okay. Now you see that? It's very soft, very loose. Okay, and lots of elasticity in the dough. You do not want to over knead the dough as well because you want those air pockets to stay Otherwise, they will all collapse when you're baking them if you over knead the dough. Okay, so there you go. Now it's time to get it all incorporated well. Now I want to knead it just for a little so I can show you what the consistency of the dough should be. You see this dough? This is how it'll be. Okay, now I'm just going to get it all incorporated together into a nice soft. You see how soft that is? It's like a little piece of sponge, see? Okay, I'm just going to make a nice small little compact bowl. Okay, put some oil in the bowl. I'm going to leave this on the side to proof for about an hour, to rise for about an hour. Usually about an hour is good. Now if it's winter and you don't have a warm place to leave this in, what you're going to do is put the oven light on, and usually that is just enough. But if you think it's really winter and the oven is not warm as well, you can put the oven on to 100 degrees Fahrenheit, 50 degrees Celsius, and then leave it on for only 5 minutes. Put the oven on, off, and then put the dough in. Okay, so basically warm the oven up, and then now after 1 hour, this is what you should have: a very soft, smooth, and you see that double in volume, you see the amount of air that's inside. Okay, that's a good dough. It's very soft. Now I'm going to take half of it for my first batch. Okay, I'm going to first give a little piece to my little girl so that she's going to be busy and let me do my work while she does her work. Now, the best way to go about it, now the first thing you need to do actually is to oil the muffin tray, otherwise your rolls will stick to the bowl. So, now the best way to do this is actually to weigh your dough. If you'd weigh them about 50 grams or 60 grams, ideally a good roll is about 60 grams, I think. But this probably is about 50. So all you need is 3 balls, and those 3 balls go right into one each cavity of the muffin pan, and that's it. That's how you make clover leaf roll. 3 balls right in there. But when they rise all together and they get, you know, fused together, that's when you get that beautiful dough roll. Okay. Now getting the balls even size is a little bit of a task sometimes. Now this is a great project to have for kids actually, because you know, if you're not looking for perfection, get them to make the balls, and well, you won't have them all even, but you will definitely have fun. Normally when I have these, if the kids are around, then they make these balls, and they like to make the balls and throw them into the muffin pans. And sometimes they will throw 4 in, sometimes they will just throw 2 in, so it's just fun for them. But normally, a clover leaf roll, you put 3 balls inside in each. Anyway, now you know how to do this. I mean, I'm not going to show you doing all of it, but one way to get the smooth ball is to kind of pinch the dough all together so that all the seams are at the bottom, then give it a nice roll. Okay, because of the yeast, it's difficult to roll them into really smooth balls, so the best is to put all the seams. Ah, well, now that's all done. All the rolls are done. Almost done. Put them inside. Okay, and I'm gonna cover this and leave it to rise for about 40 minutes. Now it won't take an hour to double, so as soon as it's double in size, you're gonna put the oven on to 190 degrees Celsius. Make sure your oven is nicely preheated, and then we're gonna stick into the oven. So my oven is preheating. After 40 minutes, my rolls are double in size. See that? Okay, now all we need is a little egg wash. Now egg wash is basically an egg yolk with a little bit of water, like a tablespoon or so of water. I use milk. You can use milk. The difference between using water and milk is that if you use milk, you get a nice, a more darker golden brown, you know, kind of you get a golden, darker color for the rolls on top, brown, whereas water gives you a more lighter, because the sugar in the milk caramelizes, and that's how you get a darker. Now this, you can spray some sesame seeds if you want. Now these usually break for about 18 to 20 minutes. Mine took about 18 minutes in my oven, but here they are. You see nice golden brown. Okay, I'm going to cover these and leave them to rest for about 10 minutes before I try to get them out of the puff and pans. Now Usually the cooling helps to get release them out as well, unless you have missed spraying the oiling the pan properly. You've got to make sure that you spray the pan before you put your rolls in. Remember I told you, okay, that you have to spray it first. So you see all of them come out very nicely. Okay, and that's it, your clover leaf rolls are done. I do hope you try this recipe. It's a very, very easy and simple recipe to make, and it's also a kid-friendly recipe because kids love making balls. And well, I do hope you try it, and if you do, please do share them with me on my Facebook page, ahomadechef.net. Thank you so much for watching. This is Veena Azmanov. Bye-bye for now.